focus off record, focus. October of 1971. We are sitting here at the Stromboli on Radio 2. What I love is we have bands in this house all the time. Right tonight, Circuit Graffiti and Lee Scratch Perry both be in my house. This house of sound we are building for you. What I especially love is when an artist comes in with their band and then they come in with their own solo stuff. And that is the case for Patrick Creef. Creef, you may know best and love best as a guitarist of the excellent Canadian rock and roll combo called last week's Tears. He was talking about his other project that he had, and it has finally come to fruition, and I'm so happy to have you here. Hey, welcome to the show.
Thanks, man.
So this new stuff that you're putting out, you're not new to solo records, you've done it, but yeah, there are a lot of songs, and you carry a lot of weight emotionally making this.
Yeah, it was, it didn't feel like a drag to make it. It just felt important, like urgent.
Why?
I don't know, I just, there was this sense of kind of like I better get this documented and recorded in case I get hit by a bus or something. Just kind of like this, you're sitting with all this finished stuff, go and get it done. It has to be done. And at the same time, I realized that the process was taking me outside of a lot of dangerous mindsets that I needed to escape from. Just kind of don't feel sorry for yourself. Don't.
You were going through a lot of shit.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that would be one way to say it.
there was a lot of loss in your life.
Yeah.
Right?
And, I've been relatively sheltered from that. And I don't think that makes me special or, everybody is going to have to deal with that at some point in their life. But
did you feel like the cloud of death was around you?
It was. There's no question. And, it's not over. People are still going since the album's been done. But I've been lucky enough to not experience much of it until that month, and then it was like a big cluster, and it made me think. It's not that I got desensitized to it, but I started having a different approach and just feeling crippled with depression. I just started thinking, you better stop wasting time, and you better start. It makes you realize what you know, a lot of things that are in your life that you might consider yourself unlucky for are there by your own invitation, and I think death really wakes you up in that way to go, I'm a victim in this situation, and I just need to get rid of that, it was inspiring in a lot of ways.
Were you talking to people, were you reading books, like what were you Googling at 2 a.m. to kind of?
What I was Googling was not death-related stuff. I was just really getting my head into things that I let go of when I was a kid that I was more interested in, sports or getting back on this idea of, instead of just chugging a bottle of whiskey and just thinking of other ways to deal with what I was feeling, physically exerting myself and eating better and complete turnover on a diet, reading a lot about things like that, and just life and the universe, why are you doing that? You shouldn't be doing that. That's not cool,
Right.
And things change,
A lot of things change. That's a pretty crazy transition to go through.
Yeah, but it was, the reward was so instant that it didn't feel like hard work. It was like everything, every change I make makes me feel better. So I'm going to just, I'm more inspired to go in that direction.
Were you amazed that you had that earlier?
There's so many things in my life that I'm like, damn, that was 11 years of ignoring that, But, I guess that's, there's a million ways to say it in cliches of, that youth is wasted on the young. Yeah.
I'll play that somewhere. So sure. Which one do I play?
Play All Is Lost.
How do you write this one?
I was actually in the back of the van. One of these guys was driving across Canada or the States, I don't remember. And I had a MIDI controller, and I just put the basic chords down for this, and I listened to the loop of that for maybe a year before I said, oh, I know what the lyrics are going to be, and just keep it in the room. And it's great.
Oh. Thank you.